I remember I had a neighbor when I was growing up. He was a little older than me. I used to call him Babai Da. Babai was his nickname, and Da because Da in India, you know, Babai Da. And I remember he used to be very talkative. You know, he was very, not just talkative, he used to share his ideas. He used to always tell us what happened at the school. He used to always tell us what happened here. And we used to play together, and we were having a lot of fun. But I remember as he grew up, you know, last time I met him, he was very silent in life. He has two kids now. He's about 42, 43, a little older than me. And he was telling, not much. He was not talking much. So I asked him, Babai Da, why don't you talk much? And he said, nothing much to talk. And I saw fear on his face. I saw nervousness. I saw frustration on his face. And it's not only that time. I've seen every single time I've met in the last 5 years, I've always seen him, you know, toned down. Are you that Babai Da also? Sometimes do you feel that you used to always sometimes express yourself, but now, you know, maybe you don't express your ideas fully because, well, you can't say everything. You have to be diplomatic, and you don't know how to express yourself fully. So in this video, what I want to do is I want to quickly talk about the five reasons why most people don't talk. I mean, like the five fears that hold people back from expressing themselves fully. Okay. So these five fears, see which ones apply to you. The first one is, what will they think? What will they think? A lot of times, maybe you are in a conference room, you know, or maybe you are actually at a social party, social gathering, and you want to say something. You have an idea in your mind. You want to say some things. You want to express, but you don't say. What will they think? That's the reason behind it. And this what will they think stops you from sharing that idea. And you come back home, you take the shower, then you say, I should have shared. I could have shared. But you don't. What will they think? The second reason, the five fears. The second is, what if my idea is not good enough? What if my idea is not good enough? I want to share that idea in that meeting, at the social party, at the social event. But what if my idea is not good enough? What if people laugh at my idea? What if I'm ignored? And if you have that, you know, thought process, I can tell you that you are digging your own grave right now. The reason you're digging your own grave is because you think someday you will do it. But just like a small seed, you know, if the small seed and you keep water it, you know, what happens is soon it becomes a plant. Then it becomes an entire tree. And now you have an entire tree called fear. Are you getting what I'm talking about? You have an entire tree of fear is because you keep thinking, what if my idea is not good enough? And that's the second fear. The third fear is, I don't know how to articulate my thoughts powerfully. I don't know. It's okay. I don't have the skills. I don't have the skills to articulate my ideas powerfully. Like, you know, you want to say something, you know, you have an idea, but the idea, when you start talking, you are not able to articulate it properly. Why? Because you don't take the risk. You know, normal Vincent Peale said many years ago that the greatest risk in life is taking no risk, because the man who risks nothing is nothing, becomes nothing, does nothing, and gets nothing. And so if you think you don't know, have the articulation properly, then guess what? You will not be able to share your idea. You will not be expressive. You will not express the idea, the million-dollar pitch. You will not be able to do that at all. For example, and I'm going to show you a quick clip right now where Palash, one of our master members, talks about how he closed a $10.5 million deal in a presentation. Check this out.
Close a deal for my organization, which is till date the biggest deal in India.
What is the size of the deal?
It's few million dollars.
Okay, like less than 10?
Around that.
Around that.
So these are the two wins for me.
How long? What was the sales cycle for?
No, so for this particular deal, Vishal, I was, because I'm saying, no, this is the biggest deal, and that too this COVID time. So that is why this has been highlighted, globally, because of COVID situation, and the obviously in respect of India, the sizing I'm talking about.
Yeah,
that's the third reason, which is I don't know how to articulate. But Palash also did not know how to articulate, but now he knows. The fourth reason, the fourth fear a lot of people have is, what if they ask me questions and I don't know how to handle them, right? What if they ask me questions? Okay. I don't have what will they think idea. I think my idea is good enough. I also know how to articulate. But what if I start articulating my idea, then they start asking question, and then I get nervous. I don't know. At that time, I look like a fool. Are you able to follow what I'm talking about so far? So these are the four fears. And the fifth fear, which is, I think, the biggest excuse in life. And that biggest excuse in life is, maybe next time. And then you start thinking next time, and then tomorrow, and the tomorrow becomes next week, and the next week becomes next month, and the next month becomes next year, the next year becomes next year, and then you have 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, and 10 years, and then you are 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, and you die with all these ideas and expressions in your head, with frustration and regret. You're going to be in a hospital looking outside the window thinking, I wish I took some action. I wish I had a public speaking coach who trained me on how to overcome my fears, on how to articulate my ideas properly. Don't let that happen. So these are the five reasons. So what will they think? This is called the judgment frame. Judgment frame. What if my ideas is not good enough? This is the confidence frame. I don't know how to articulate my ideas powerfully. This is a skill frame. You don't have the skill properly how to articulate. What if they ask me questions that I don't know how to handle that? It's a Q&A frame. You don't know how to handle Q&A properly. And maybe next time, this is a procrastination frame. Right? So you're being illusioned by judgment. What will they think? Or confidence. What if my idea is not good enough? Or you don't have the skill, that's why you think, I don't know how to articulate my ideas, thoughts properly. You don't have the proper Q&A skills, that's the reason you think, what if they ask me questions that I don't know how to handle? Or you think you have the procrastination, maybe next time. Now, I don't know exactly what your situation is right now, but I believe that if you are having these five fears, I'll tell you, man, like, honestly, you have a big question mark about your life ahead. Do you understand what I'm talking about? Like, sometimes the life can go up, sometimes the life can go down. But what I really want you to understand is, this is not you. You deserve better. You deserve to take the bull by the horns, because I believe, Tipu Sultan said many years ago, it's better to live like a lion for 1 year than to live like a goat for 10 lifetimes. When will you start demanding the best from yourself? If you're ready to do that, I can tell you exactly how. So if you are ready to overcome all these five fears, and if you want to have complete power and confidence, and if you really want to have, first of all, if you want to have the confidence, if you want to have expression, and if you want to have authority, so that you can become an unforgettable speaker. If you want to do that, then I recommend you come join us inside our program. It's not a theoretical program, guys. We do not have any recorded workshop at a cheap level where, you know, you buy some course where you're logging in just to watch videos. We train you practically. Is that okay? It's a practical program, nothing theoretical, only practical. I teach you practically. I give you actionable strategies, different techniques and methods, and exactly how to use it. I make you do it by hook or by crook. Do you understand what I'm saying right now? You have practical synergy, accountability. I'll handhold you. I'll make you speak. I'll correct your mistakes. I'll give you correction. I'll give you feedback. I'll give you coaching. I'll answer your questions. I'll clear your doubts to make sure that you have my handholding and the pinpointing to make sure that you have the total information and complete implementation and direction and correction for complete practical transformation. The word is practical. What's the word? Practical transformation. If that's what you want, I want you to take out your phone and call the number you can see on the screen right now, where we'll be happy to talk to you and see if you are the right fit for our program. We take a very limited amount of people inside our program because our program is not for everybody. If you want to know more, call us right now. Take out your phone because the ball is in your court right now. The ball is in your court. Like, you know, Norman Vincent Peale said, right? The greatest risk in life is no risk at all, because the man who risks nothing is nothing, becomes nothing, and is can do nothing at all. So take out your phone, call our number. I hope you enjoyed this video. These are the five fears that you need to overcome, okay? And once you overcome that, you can be a powerful speaker. Vishal Sarkar here reminding you, public speaking is not about perfection. It's all about connection.
Hi, I'm Kripa. I work as operations manager in Bangalore. My biggest challenge is I went through some, you know, lowest point in my life. So I was finding it very difficult to, you know, talk to people. I used to corner myself. I didn't have a courage to go in front of people and, you know, place myself in a right position. You know, always it was a setback in my life. Now, after when I found out this Vishal Sarkar's website, when I went through, and I start, it's been a journey, you know, though it is a short journey till now. I thought there is a place where I can explore myself, my potential. So it's basically unlocking myself.
I presented an audience of 150 people. Just few months ago, I could not even speak to an audience of 15 people. Forget about 150 people. I would just go blank on the stage. I would completely lose my chain of thought. I used to be so nervous on the stage. To think of those days, today I am a much more confident person. I can address a very large audience easily. I attribute all these changes to Mr. Vishal Sarkar's public speaking courses, mastermind sessions, and of course all the honest effort that I put as part of it.
I have actually public speaking fear, that's a stage fear. I can talk, I can teach hours together with respect to my subject, but whenever I go on stage in front of a big audience, so I'll get nervous and I have that stage fear. Yeah, I came to know my weakness, why I am getting stage fear, because Vishal has told me that you are not accepting the appreciation that is given by others. So that's why I was expecting perfection everywhere. So I came to know that I should take the appreciation positively and move forward. So that has built my confidence.
Yeah, in fact, today I was taking, just to share with all, I was today addressing a group of people at NGO online for about an hour, where, you know, so there is a cancer society for which we conduct a CSR activity, and their parents, they come from all over India, and Tata Memorial, they guide them to an NGO. So all those NGO people, parents, I was addressing today for about an hour or so with my MD and a couple of them. So just wanted to share some good
things. Wow, that's amazing. Yeah. Clap it up for
Anup. Thanks.
I presented an audience of 150 people.